Next property, which is going to be an important one in your school exam. A little while ago, we saw that A plus A transpose, if A is any square matrix, will always be symmetric. Correct? So we saw that A plus A transpose will always be symmetric. We also saw that if any symmetric matrix is multiplied to a scalar quantity, that will also be symmetric. So overall, can I say this is a symmetric matrix? Yes, sir. Similarly, I also discussed that A minus A transpose will always be skew symmetric. Look at the very first set of properties which we discussed. Any skew symmetric matrix multiplied to a scalar quantity will also be a skew symmetric matrix. Correct? If you add it, what do you get? What do you get? A back. That means any square matrix can actually be written as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix, very similar to the property that we have learned in functions, that any function can be written as the sum of an even and an odd function. Correct? See the analogy that is between matrices and the numbers themselves. I think I have not done that concept with you, but I'll soon be doing it in functions chapter, that any function can be written as the sum of an even function and an odd function. In a similar way, any square matrix can be broken down as a sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. And this is going to be one of the prospective questions for you in your school tests and exams, where they would give you a matrix A and they'll ask you, write it down as a sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. So will you be able to do that? Let's take a small example, a question based on this. Express the matrix A as a sum of symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. Fourth property right now. If A is a symmetric matrix, then raising A to the power of n, where n is a positive integer, will all be symmetric or cannot say that depends upon A. What's your call? Symmetric, can you prove it? Use the property of transpose which I discussed with you. Okay, so if A is symmetric, it implies A transpose is A, correct? Now we have learned that any matrix, let's say this you are transposing it, it is as good as transpose A, correct? Please note, any matrix, if you are raising it to a power of n, by the way, when can you raise a matrix to a power of n? It has to be a square matrix for that, right? Why I'm saying that? Because if it were like, let's say, A square cube, you can only do when it is A into A, right? Correct? If this is M cross N, this is also M cross N, unless until these two gentlemen are same, multiplication cannot happen. Correct? So when you're raising a matrix to an integral power or positive integral power, you can only do it when the matrix is a square matrix. So we know this property, and we know from this that A transpose is going to be A back again. That means transposing A to the power n gives you A to the power n, which means A to the power n will also be symmetric. Is that fine? If A is a skew symmetric matrix, what can you comment upon A to the power n? What's the conclusion?
Symmetric is an odd number.
Okay, now here the conclusion is, if n is odd, then it would be skew symmetric. And if n is even, it would again be symmetric. Is that right? How do we show this? Very simple. If let's say, I want to find A to the power n transpose, According to the property, it is A transpose to the power n. And we know that A transpose is negative A. Okay. Now, if your n is positive, if your n is even, it will give you back A to the power n. In that case, the result would become a symmetric matrix, isn't it? Because you are starting from this and you are ending up this, and this will only happen when A is even. Okay? And it would become negative A to the power n when n is odd. That means it will become a skew symmetric matrix when n is odd. Asha, how many of you have done inverse of a matrix in school at least? So I'll come to the property little later on. Okay? Anyways. So let's take questions based on this. Let's see what type of questions are framed on the use of these properties. Question number one. If A and B are symmetric. I'll just write a short form for symmetric. And it is known that AB is BA. Then A inverse B is option A symmetric, option B is skew symmetric, option C unit matrix. Option D, none of the above. By the way, I would like to highlight here itself that if A is symmetric, so will be its inverse. I think the property of transpose will help us in this. So if you do A transpose, okay, sorry, if you do A inverse transpose, it's as good as A transpose inverse. Okay? That means you're back to A inverse. So you started with A inverse transpose and you are back to A inverse. What does it mean? A inverse will also be symmetric.
So first
Symmetric?
Yeah.
What is the answer of Kutsi? What is it? Symmetric? Very easy question. So you just have to do the transpose of this. What do you get? You get B transpose, A inverse transpose, right? Which is nothing but B transpose is going to be B itself. This is going to be A transpose inverse, which is going to be A inverse itself. Okay? Now what do you do? Now do a multiplication of, I want to get to this term or negative of this term. So what should I do in this case?
A inverse
is symmetric. A inverse is not.
So what is this?
I want to reach to this value. What will I do then? Have I used this property yet?
No.
Can I use it? How?
A and B will be symmetric. That implies A and B will be symmetric.
I didn't get it.
These first two conditions imply that A and B will be symmetric.
AB is symmetric.
Yeah. So,
what should we do? So, two symmetric matrices multiplying is symmetric.
So, how do you show that this is same as A inverse?
Because A. So, because
A inverse is symmetric,
B is also symmetric. Wait, so multiplying two symmetric matrices will if AB is equal to BA, you always
No, 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 you're not getting my question. The question is there is some matrix, you're transposing it. If you claim that this is symmetric, you should get back the same matrix over here. Plain and simple.
So multiply by A on both sides.
Okay.
Well, you get identity matrix, it becomes BI.
Oh, A.
It becomes BI.
Yeah.
B BI is clear. See, what I have to prove here? I have to prove here somehow that this and this are same, right? Is it? This is what I have to prove? Can you not prove this? Okay, let me start with LHS. A inverse B we have. Correct? Can I do one thing first? Can I multiply? Let me take both the matrices together. Can I multiply this with? Can I multiply this with? Prefacto A. Okay. Prefacto A means multiplying before. So this also have to be multiplying with prefacto A. Correct. So A inverse is known to be I, so I get a B, correct? Now here, we know that AP and BA are same, so can I flip the position of this? Can I make this AB as BA as per the given condition in the question? Now we know that matrix multiplication is associative, so now I can multiply these two together first, which is again I. You know BI is B only, just like here IB is equal to this. So basically B is equal to B, which means the assumption that A inverse B and B inverse A are same is actually correct. So you can put this back as A inverse B, and therefore transposing any matrix giving you the same matrix back implies that matrix was symmetric. Okay, now these are the properties which are helping us to solve this question. We never assumed any matrix to be something. We solved it just by the use of properties. Let's take another one. Next is, if A, B and A plus B are non-singular matrices. Now by the way, we have not officially learned what a singular non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix is basically a matrix whose determinant or whose inverse can be found out. Okay? That means it is invertible. Then, A into A plus B inverse into B whole inverse.
Oh, by the way, we have not done inverse properly. Wait, one second. Sorry about that, we have not learned inverse properly.
If P is given by root 3 by 2 half minus half root 3 by 2. Q is given by 1101. Sorry, not Q. A is given by 1101. And Q is given by PAP transpose. And X is given by P transpose Q to the power 2005 P. Okay? Then find the matrix X. Everybody knows the basic of inverse of a matrix, correct? Just like here, A inverse is I, A inverse A is also I. That is something which you all, that's all we need to know to solve this also. All we need to know is A inverse and A inverse A, both are equal to an identity matrix. Okay, I know many of you will have no clue how to solve this. First of all, I would like to know from you, if I say Q to the power 2005, what does it mean? Q into Q into Q into Q, how many times? Two solving times. That means you have to write PAP transpose, PAP transpose, PAP transpose. PAP transpose almost 2500, 2500, correct? Now, when you see, I would like all of you to tell me what will happen if you multiply P transpose into P. All of you please do this operation. P transpose, this is your P transpose, into P.
Minus P squared. Minus P squared.
Minus P squared.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because P transpose is equal to minus P.
What is the P squared? Can you simplify it further?
R.
What is the value of this?
1.4.
If I had to write P squared only, I would not have mentioned what is P at all. Brinda, do it. I'm just telling you the process, you don't have to think anything, you just do as I say. Just do P transpose into P. Tell me the answer.
So 5.4001.
It's an identity matrix. Prashant? What is it? 8. 3/4 + 1/4 is 1. 3/√3/4 - √3/4 = 0. √3/4 - √3/4 = 0. 1/4 + 3/4 is 1. You get an identity matrix, isn't it? Yes or no? So can I say this two term could be clubbed as I? Similarly here this could be clubbed as I. And like that, let's say before this there was a term PAP transpose. Even this could be clubbed as an I. So, do you see that even this would have clubbed with something and become I, even this would have clubbed with something and become I? So, can I say this entire expression q to the power 2005 is nothing but p a to the power of 2005 into p transpose? Because it will be a i like that. A i is a only. a into 2005. Now, there is something very special in a that a to the power 2005 can be found out. Just by doing a square a cube, you will automatically see the pattern. Just do a square. A square means okay. So this will be 1, this will be 2, this will be 0, and this will be 1 again, correct? A cube means a square into a. So just try multiplying this with a again. 1, 1, 0, 1. So this will be 1. This will be 3. This will be 0. This will be 1 again.
So only
do you see that? Only this guy is changing. Correct? Correct? So if you continue the trend, I can say a to the power 2005 will be 1, 0, 2005 into 1. Yes or no? Okay? Now, the question was finding x. X itself was p transpose p a to the power 2005 into p transpose. Into p. Now again, these two gentlemen will become ii. And that means a to the power 2005 itself is your answer. So this becomes your answer. Isn't it? Q was actually. What did we find out? We found out this part. Isn't it? This was a to the power, this was this term, correct? Now this you have to pre-multiply with a transpose, post-multiply with p. So if I pre-multiplied with p transpose, post-multiplied with p. So p transpose p is back to I again. And p transpose into p is back to I. So it's I a to the power 2005 I, which is a to the power 2005. So whatever you got for a to the power 2005, that would be your answer. Is that right?